official starter with the green flag in hand, and here we go. We're racing in heat one.
Involving Glenn Orr came out prior to one completed lap. Now the light has been turned off and starter Jim with a green flag in hand, ready to wave it down so we get set to go. There it is! Green flag!
Watch out! Oriola off the bank in turn one! He shot way straight off of turn one. He's still moving and coming back around. Gets back onto the racetrack now. He was still moving there with the last climb over there.
Kevin Jones!
Assisted by Terry Basher as we get set to go one more time. Double file alignment now as they come through the third turn.
Car number two jumps out front. Harold Thomas in car number one in second spot now. Here comes Chris Speaker and 56 up from near the back of the pack. He's third. Hardesty, Thomas and Speaker third. Fourth is Rick Myers. Fifth belongs to Lon Schmitter. He drew out off the fourth turn.
Dives to the inside now, Jerry Cook. Mueller is
bringing up the rear. Green flag gets out. Here we go. Randy Archer bringing up the outside of the fifth post. We've got a green flag. Watch out! We got a spin out down in turn number two. 27 Randy Archer has spun it out in turn number two. And he's still sitting there. We'll see if he has to take the yellow flag.
In Shenandoah. Hope you're with us. All right, here's the field off the fourth turn as we get set to go. The green flag is out. We're ready.
Bill Barber in car number 99 shoots the inside of the racetrack down in turn two. Randy Dixon in car number 66 leading the pack down into turn two, but we've got cars off the track down in the second turn.
And Dash for Cash, eight events. And starter Jim with a green flag, he waves it.
Here comes Rich Mercer, dives to the inside, and can he make the turn sharp enough? Yeah. Three abreast as they come off the second corner now. Here comes Jerry Carlson in the 75 car. He's in the second spot now. The leader is Randy Dixon in car number 66. Dixon and Carlson both fighting the high line now. Six off turn four. Randy Dixon, Jerry Carlson down to the inside. Look out! Rich Mercer off to his front. Down in the infield, he's back out on the racetrack. Here's your leader, Jerry Carlson, car number 75. Dixon trying to hold off Craig Clark for that second spot. Dixon on the outside, Craig Clark down the inside. Clark now off the second spot. Third place belongs to the 55 of Dave Say. Fourth place, Randy Day.
71, Max Morris bringing up the rear of the field. Fourth and final Pro Street Heat event, six times five.
John Bensing of car number 18 to the outside. Here comes Ron Gay in the ninth car right behind him. Trying to thread the needle. Tim Richard Rigby in the 79 car. Jack Hewlett in car number 23 in the second spot now. The leader is Richard Rafe. Jack Hewlett. Rick Rogers in car number 17 fighting it out for third place now with Joe Herbert. Herbert in car number 61 and Rogers get together as they come off the second turn. A little bit of contact between those two. Anders down on the inside, Herbert along the outside. Here's your top pair. Rafe and Hewlett. Anders down in the third place ahead of Joe Herbert.
Yeah.
right, Mike Washburn. Track is clear and should see a green flag fly this time by. Once again, the laps probably will be cut here.
Thank you.
Park pace track brings them by in front of the grandstand. Hey, let's one last time stand up in the grandstand and really let them have it as they come down the front stretch. Let them know you're up there. Cheer them on. To go with a final victory of 93. Here we go. Von Schlitter, those two drivers sitting side by side on the sixth row. As we get set to start this 15-lap A-Day, they're going to go around one more time. Randy Archer, Scott Carlson, Mark Carr, Doug Lund, and Darrell Gowdy. Ready to go. 15 laps the distance for the Funk Pro Street A-Day. Jim Richmond, that green flag in hand. Here we go!
A black tie line, five, pace it in. Black tie on the Lander's car.
If something happens to Greg Miller, then Schluter could win the title. Still an open up there. Let's see what happens here. 6 laps to go. Green flag. Thank you.
feature later tonight. Yeah. What a terrific run for this young man from Mount Mesina, Iowa. Ladies and gentlemen, Henry Erickson. First feature victory in the Sorensen Stealthy Erickson Farm sponsored entry. Rick Gerber whipped it down there in turn two.
Oh, Johnny, we did it.
You betcha.
Hanson fourth, and Rick Thistle rounds out the top five.
Made off, all the work.
Now, our final feature race of the year. NASCAR late models coming out. On the pole, car number 97 from Fort Calhoun, Nebraska, Chad Jorgensen. Outside, car number 23 from Kansas City, Kansas.
The big gorilla got it.
Inside, row two, car number one from Omaha, Bill Del Nari. Outside, car number 49, Dr. Rinda, Mike Whitehead. Car number 38, from Omaha, Al Frisdell. Outside of him, the number 60, from Bellevue, Nebraska, Dale Zeitner.
Where's Mama Erickson at?
Where's
Leanne? She down there?
Outside the 2H from Nottoway, John Hempel. Sixth row, car number 31 from Omaha, Dave Chase. Outside, ready to do battle as they come through the third and fourth turns. Great turn is out, here we go. Thank you. And your winner, John Hempel. And his crew celebrating that
down in
the tech area as John Hempel secured feature winners from 1993 for all the
event.
75, Jerry Carlson, Team 93, and they are set to go for six laps and a hunk and change put up by Sardison Racing. Here to the winner of this race. Here we go. Red flag is up. Round the outside, down the back stretch. Car number 56, Chris Speaker. Second place is Frank Miller, and Jerry Carlson riding in third spot. Down to the inside is car number 15, Ron Schwerter.
Modified features this year. Donnie McClellan was one.
you want to feature back off the Tim Peterson, Stan Slagle, and Mark Hansen did not win features, so they had to add those two next time. Your leader is Carter with 33, Donnie McCullough, Jim Peterson.
Feature. You know, if we'd had a welder, we would have got it back together, but we just didn't have time.
Well, you really served notice in that heat race when he came from the back, charged to the front. I think it really showed everybody just how fast your car was tonight.
Yeah, the car was just working awful good, you know. It's even in that feature, it didn't matter. We could just go, you know. I mean, we've been trying for that for a long time. This car was fast back in June when we won those three in a row, and we haven't really necessarily been slow, but we just haven't been satisfied. We really put everything we had into this car this week, trying to get back to where we was. And I want to thank all these people standing here behind you, because without them guys, I'd just be in the pits wishing I could race.
Well, let's name these guys. They're a team effort. Let's give them some recognition, shall we?
Greg Hample, Ernie Sambaugh, Mike Archer, Susan Bird, Mike Meyer, Don Meyer. Of course, old Monty.
I'll tell you, boy, he decimated the field here tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, Pat Erickson. Wow! Boy, it's some kind of night for you to end up here.
Yeah, it's quite a surprise. I didn't know if I ever had it in me this year, but we're lucky enough to get one.
I'm trying to think back. This is the first one, isn't it?
First one ever.
Boy, and you've been at it, what, 2-3 years now?
Yeah, this is my third year.
What was the secret for you tonight? Boy, you're really running quick right out the get-go.
Well, I got out in open air, and everybody else is battling for position. And got in that high groove and run smooth and run a good race.
Oh, congratulations. And the high groove was worth the best place to run here tonight?
Yeah, it seemed like to me it was.
Well, I'll tell you what, it's probably a good thing that they ended up the night with that trophy dash the way that thing ended up right there at the end, huh?
Yeah, well, we got put out in the trees last week and tore it up. We tore it up tonight, but at least it's over with.
Congratulations. Boy, this leaves a good taste in your mouth heading into the winter, doesn't it?
You bet. All out next year.
Great. How about a nice hand for Pat Erickson, winner of tonight's feature. Thanks, Pat.
Thank you.
And here's a guy that not only claimed the feature win tonight, but he ends up the night by winning the Sardison Feature Winner's Trophy Dash. Ladies and gentlemen, here he is standing next to the Woodpecker Special, by the way, a car's for sale. And we're going to talk a little bit about future plans for this young man right here that won another feature here tonight. And also the Trophy Dash. Congratulations, Chris Speaker.
Thank you very much.
I'll say, I lost track. Is this number 4 or 5?
This is number 3 this year.
Well, 3, is that all?
Yeah, we didn't get too many this year.
I forgot to look just exactly how many you did win, but I'll tell you something. This car, once you got, you know, you've had some troubles not finishing some races this year, but once you got where you could run, you've been running up towards the top just about every night out.
Yeah, well, we've had a lot of top 5 finishes and everything, just, and been pretty fortunate. Got hit by wrecks and everything. Last week we wasn't quite as lucky though. It tore up pretty good, but evidently we got it back, put back together right, because it was running good tonight, handling good and everything like that.
Well, I tell you, in your first 3 seasons of competition, you really served notice that you're a very tough competitor. What's the future plans now? You got this car for sale. What are you going to do next year?
Yeah, the car's for sale. We really haven't decided yet. It depends on how much we can get the car sold for and everything, but we either want to try to build a late model motor and see if we can get hooked up with the guy that does all my motor work and helps me out tremendously. Whenever I take the motor out, he pretty much puts me in front of everybody. That's Dave Hill from Dave's Crankshaft Machine there in Council Bluffs. Either we're going to do that or maybe try building a Monte Carlo so we can race throughout the state, IMCA, and if we have to, I guess we're going to have to go down to a small block.
So you'd like to try some different racetracks, get some experience on different kinds of racetracks, right?
Yeah, just kind of get well-known throughout the state. Kind of like Verrill Schmidt and Ernie Stender. About anywhere you go in the state, everybody knows and remembers them. So that's just kind of what I'd like to do.
Well, that's a tradition you're following and following very well. Congratulations to you. Great season, great finish.
Thanks. I got to give a special thanks to my brother. Without him, I wouldn't be out here every week, that's for sure. He spends a lot of time on the car during the week. And Scott Carstens, another one, he couldn't be here tonight. He had another deal he had to go to tonight, but he's there every night helping me. I got to thank my aunt and Uncle Connie. Without them, it'd be tough running every week. They help me out with sponsorship and everything. John Kent Bagshaw, he's there giving me money and helping in the garage and everything. Mike Bagshaw tapes for me. I gotta thank all my sponsors this year. A couple of them got tore off because last week, but hopefully they didn't care too much. That's Dice Construction and Fulman Sons Hampton Spots, so we got them in. The rest of them are on the card. There's too many to name. I just gotta thank everybody.
Fans, just come on down and take a look. Just look around the entire car. You'll gather it all in. You might even want to buy this car. Who knows, huh?
Yeah, come talk to me. I gotta thank my mom and dad too. Without them, it'd be really tough to run.
Great show.